Hey, what's going on guys? Chris here, and today I'll be telling you 8 cool facts and things that you probably didn't know about Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. So, here goes. Before the name Advanced Warfare was finalised, the game had a special code name and was often referred to as Blacksmith by the developers and teams that worked on it. Why did it have the nickname Blacksmith? Well, because it was Sledgehammer Games who developed it. And the link is that Blacksmiths kinda use sledgehammers. Advanced Warfare was the first title that Sledgehammer Games had full control over the development, as normally it's Infinity Ward and Treyarch that developed the Call of Duty games, though Sledgehammer did co-develop Modern Warfare 3, so they weren't completely new to the franchise. This is why Advanced Warfare had the nickname Blacksmith. Now we all know that Jonathan Irons looks almost identical to his real-life counterpart Kevin Spacey, and we can pretty much recognise him straight away. But he's not the only one to have a video game version of himself in Advanced Warfare. In fact, most of the main characters in the game's story mode look like the voice actors in real life. Jump in. I'll give you the tour. Hit him again. Remember that huge walking tank that almost stomps on your head near the beginning of the game? And the one you get to control later on in the game in the Biolab mission. Well, believe it or not, NASA is actually creating a similar one, to undergo future missions to mine asteroids. Though it probably won't have all the bells and whistles that the one in the game has. I don't think it'd really need all that firepower on an asteroid, to be honest. Unless a bunch of xenomorphs decide to show up, which I highly doubt. I bet you never expected to be playing Frogger on a Call of Duty game, but perhaps one of the most challenging and unexpected forms of death doesn't come in the form of a grenade explosion or a bullet to the face, but in the form of road raging pedestrians who just don't seem to mind at all about the fact that they've just casually ran you over. On the mission Traffic, you have to cross some pretty busy roads without getting run down. There's also parts where pedestrians are seen driving quite badly. The funny thing is that this isn't just a random thing that Sledgehammer have put into the game. They've actually done some homework here, and it turns out that Lagos, which is the city that the mission takes place in, has some of the busiest traffic in the world. It's also got a reputation for having a lot of dangerous drivers, hence why the mission's called Traffic in the first place. Recognise the name of that non-playable character you just ran past in the street? Probably not, but if you're one of the lucky members of Sledgehammer, High Moon Studios or Raven who all worked on Advanced Warfare, then you just might, as they could have the same surname as you. All the developers' names who helped create the game were randomly selected, and some were given the opportunity to feature as NPCs in the final game. Although they probably don't look like the real-life counterparts, it's a nice little bonus for the devs, having their own names pop up on screen. And of course, all of their names can be seen collectively at the end on the credits. Now, Advanced Warfare's main protagonist, Jack Mitchell, aka the guy you play as through the campaign, might sound familiar if you're an avid gamer. He's voiced by the well-known voice actor Troy Baker, who's been in loads of recent games. Not only is he Mitchell from Call of Duty, but he's also Joel from The Last of Us, Delson from Infamous Second Son, Booker from Bioshock Infinite, Pagan Min from Far Cry 4, the Arkham Knight, Two-Face and Red Hood in Batman Arkham Knight, and he's voiced in loads of other games too. If there's a AAA game, there's a good chance that Troy Baker will be in it. In Advanced Warfare story, Kevin Spacey plays the role of Jonathan Irons, the founder and president of the private military corporation Atlas. Throughout the campaign, Irons has a very negative view on the US government, and wants to overthrow it. But Spacey also plays another character, Frank Underwood, in the Netflix series House of Cards, where his character has pretty much the complete opposite mindset towards the government that his Advanced Warfare counterpart has. The Call of Duty franchise is one of the biggest, if not the biggest, shooters in the world. Now, unless you've been living on a cave in the moon for the past 7 or so years, you probably already knew that. But according to stats, up to the release of Advanced Warfare, more than 32.3 quadrillion bullets have been fired in COD games since the release of the first title back in 2003. Some Call of Duty fans play the games religiously, and if all the time of everyone who's ever played on a Call of Duty game was added up, it'd be over 2.85 million years since the first title. Now that's a lot of time playing COD. Just think, you probably contributed to them statistics. So guys, that's just about it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it and found it interesting. And if you did, make sure you give that like button a click. And if you want to see a whole bunch of guides, commentaries, and episodes just like this one, why not subscribe too? If you haven't already, that is. Take it easy, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.